So good morning everyone, welcome to this lovely sunny Friday morning. Today, just like a little medley, we're just kind of going to have a nice sweet flow around the mats. If at any point it just gets a little bit too much for you, take a wee rest, you know, just hop down into tabletop or into downward facing dog, or just simply stand depending where you're at. Okay. So we're going to start in our Supadanakanasa. So kind of planting your bums in the middle of the mat and dropping the soles of the feet together, let the knees roll out nice and wide, just gently roll down. And relax the back of the head into the mat. Lift the buttocks and kind of let them smooth out so you've got that lovely space going through the line of the spine into the sacrum. Just resting the hands onto the front hips. And just allowing yourself a little bit of time here just to adjust into the hip opener and feel that you're focusing your awareness on your breath. Softening all the parts of the body and just releasing any tension maybe that's just sort of crept in over the course of this morning or even just through this week. And as you let go, you probably find it's something that you just didn't really need in the first place. And as we set our intention for our practice today, just allow yourself to flow around your mat, just being right where you are. And each moment that unfolds, so from here, we'll just gently draw the two knees together. Walk the feet in a little bit. Okay, smooth the lower back into the mat again, and then heel toe the feet out almost as wide as the mat. Bring the arms away from the body. And we're just going to flip flop the knees from side to side. Give a little extra press down with the inside thighs and swing the leg across. And then we're going to slow the breath for the moment. We'll just press it down and hold. And then we'll slow it out to the other side, press it down, hold. Lovely. Once you bring the knees back to centre, you can walk the feet up the mat a little bit. Try and keep the mat quite wide, quite as wide, almost as wide as the mat here. Okay. Feel the back of the head resting on the mat, smooth the lower back into the mat. And then we're just going to roll up into a nice wide leg bridge pose. So glue the feet into the floor. And just pressing the hips up nicely, just lengthening the front of the thighs, to the sideways into that chest wall. And just soften into the back of the neck. So nice wide base bridge pose is nice, especially if you have any kind of tension in the lower back. And as we gently peel the spine back down, so we're really trying to connect through each vertebrae, then lift the feet, find the outside edge, just swing the feet back, knees wide, into our happy baby. From here again, just gently drawing down on the side edges of the feet, really lengthening the spine. And breathing deeply into the tummy, into the pelvis, into the hip groins, hip creases. I didn't know we had hip groins until I just made that word up. So good gentle pull down without kind of inducing tension. There's going to be tension building up from your resistance to the stretch in the hips. So try not to build that up, just breathe into it. Lovely. And then from here, as we release legs, we're going to take them up into our Dandasana staff pose legs. Just rest the arms at either side of the body. Make a nice press up to the heels, draw the toes down towards the nose. So we're going to keep the left leg nice and active up to the sky. We're going to go for a couple of right leg swings. So if you press up to your right heel, draw the right toes down towards the nose. That will keep that leg nice and active. And then with the flexion in that right foot, just up and down. Feeling how the tummy engages for you as the leg lowers and lifts. Lovely. So the next time you bring it up, we're just going to swing it behind our left leg. Okay, cross it over knee, hold on to the two kneecaps and just gently draw the thighs in. A very simple supine pigeon pose. So just stretch of all wings slightly into your left hip. Okay, when you're breathing, and imagine your buttocks are balloons, and you're just blowing them up with that lovely in breath. And just releasing tension with the out breath. From here, we will slide the hands down the side edges and find the outside edges of the feet. Splay out that right foot a little bit wider. Come into a supine cow's face and press the feet back and down. So this will increase the stretch you feel in that left hip. And again, you want to feel like you're really sending breath into the lower part of your back, into the hips, into the buttocks. Lovely. And then we'll release the two legs back up to the sky, just bring that lovely flexion. Back is fully compressed into the floor. And this time, whilst keeping our right leg active, we're going to swing this leg up and down. So just a nice gentle mobilization of that hip joint. Okay, a little kind of wake up to our abs. And then on the next time we bring this leg up, we're just going to swing around, cross over, hold on to each knee, just gently draw those thighs in. So now this switches out to our right side here. So big breath in, maintain the stretch as you breathe out, so you kind of push past a certain point. And then we'll slide the hands down the side edges of the feet. Okay, so if you can get to the feet, ankles are loose. Splay that lovely left foot further out forwards towards your ear. I should say backwards towards your ear. And gently draw the feet back and down without peeling the bum off the floor. You've got to feel like you're lengthening down into your tailbone here as you bring the legs back. Lovely. Right. And then from here, we're going to reach those two lovely legs up to the sky again in our supine downdog. Now from here, we're going to go for a little roll, okay, with our right knee bent and foot flex. So when we roll to the front of the mat, you use your hands to push up off the floor a little bit and then roll back down. So you're rolling and you're pushing up, okay? Now, if you want, you can try and do it with the hands, just trying to get the bum off the floor. And away from the up the leg. And we're rolling back down as if we're coming back into Kapalasana. Lovely. Last time to roll back. As you roll it forward, just gently lower the leg. Place the sole of the right foot to the inside left leg. Draw the sit bones back. And we're going to lift up out of our waist and have a nice fold here. Okay, so it doesn't really matter if you don't have a belt with you, okay? If you feel it really rounding and curling and reaching, just place the hands onto the thigh, press the elbows that way, lift the chest forward, and really hinge from your hip flexor. Okay, so again, you're not trying to round and curl, we're trying to lift and lengthen. And just gently press that right knee out, soften into that right hip. As we come to center, just extend that right leg beside the left, and we're going to roll it back into our Kapalasana. So just grab it onto the side edge of the mat, and just taking a moment just to soften into the back of the neck, and reach yourself up and over. So for some of us, particularly if the spine's not going on, there's a lot of resistance that goes on in the back of the neck, and there's hyperflexion. So just try and breathe out into it. And then as we roll forward, okay, we're going to now bend our left knee, flex that left foot, and the same thing here. Rolling forwards and back, either using the hands to lift you, or just pushing the foot into the mat. Just have a little baby elephant rolling up and down. Lovely. And again, I'm going to lie, make sure you're sitting onto your mat. Place the sole of the foot, right foot inside thigh, draw length into your right leg. And again, we're going to come out into this fold. So again, either just placing the hands on the thighs and just draw the elbows back, shoulders back, so we lengthen the fronts of our bodies. So it doesn't really matter how far down that leg it goes. It's more about finding the hinge and then bending from the hinge. Occasionally just drawing and lifting that sit bone back and releasing into your left hip. Big, lovely, soothing, replenishing breaths as you do this. Lovely, and then as we come to centre, just extend that lovely leg out in front of you. We're going to roll that into that whole last one again. Good. And from here, just gently start peeling the spine back down onto the floor, bit by bit, by bit, by bit. Once the lower back comes, we're going to bring the soles of the feet together. Gently lower the feet down, extend them out and away from you. Smooth the butt cheeks into the mat. So we're not a really deep cobbler's pose. We've got the feet out quite far in front of us. We're going to reach the arms overhead. And as we exhale, we're going to roll up and reach past the fingers, the toes. And kind of press it forwards. So as you're coming into the forwards motion of this, don't let the knees pull in, let them drop out. Shimmy out the butt cheeks, we'll have a little hold of our toes and gently press the knees down. Sit up nice and tall, so feel like super duper hip stretch here. Good, so using the energy of the legs independently to gently draw those outside thighs down. Trying to maintain where you've got and go from that just another little bit. Lovely. From here, just release the feet forward a little bit, roll back down, place the arms away from the body, and then we'll gently lift the pelvis up so we're coming into a lovely diamond-shaped bridge pose. And feeling those lovely glutes engaging, finding the steadiness by the side edges of the feet, really anchoring into the mat. Lovely, and as we release it down, just swing lovely two knees together, tuck the knees into the chest, throw the feet over, roll them up, just into a little squat at the front of your mat. So you'll be slightly back from front of that, which is fine, just tip the fingertips onto the floor. As we pop the heels down, don't straighten the legs fully, but lengthen down the legs so that we've got this lovely hinge forward fold, but nice length bend knees. So from here, just gently mobilising the back leg, we're lifting the sit bones up, not necessarily straightening them. And as we drop into the crown of the head. Lovely, we'll tip the fingertips down to the floor, coming into that Ardha Uttanasana. From here, just want you to step your right foot forward, okay, a bit down from the half. Bend your left knee, straighten out your right leg, so you've got two knees interlocked either side. Okay. We're lifting our butt cheek up and just gently folding them. Okay, so you can creep the arms forward here. Okay, you can creep them back. If they're not reaching the floor, you can rest on the shins. Of course, if you have blocks available, you can use your blocks. So just finding something that works for you to really draw the butt cheeks back and up. Lovely. And then with those fingertips tipped onto the floor, we're going to sweep that right leg back into a standing arm. Really push back into that heel. Soften the pelvis, the one hip is beside the other. And then like little ballerina, we're going to take our right toes to our left outside heel. So it's like a little right angle shape. And then gently fold down. So this will quite nicely lift into our IT band. So still doing literally a forward fold down that left leg. And then we'll take the fingertips on the floor, step the right foot beside the left, and then take the left foot forward just that little bit. Bend the knee of the right leg, pull back, smooth the feet into the mat. Make sure both feet are nice and straight. Okay, so finding your placement position. Lift and lengthen, and then lift over. So draw that left hip cheek nicely up to the sky, right butt cheek as well. We're pressing down into the heel, ball and toe of our right foot. Lovely. One more breath here. And then as we bring the hands back, we're going to straighten into our left leg and push it back into a standing L. So we've got this lovely, real nice right angle between our left leg and our right leg. And then just like a little ballerina, left toes are coming to the back of the right side edge of the foot. Okay. Our forward fold is down the right leg here, so make sure you're not trying to turn away from it, because that's also going to get a real nice lift into the IT band here. Square onto four corners of both feet so that we're not compensating. Lovely. And then as we tip the fingertips through, place that left foot beside the right. Gently roll the way up to stand. Nice big inhale. Reach the arms up. Lovely. Exhaling the hands to heart. Give yourself a little moment here. Recentering on the mat. Okay. And then from here, we will just step into our chair pose. Okay. So sending the tailbone down, gluing into the feet. Relaxing the shoulders. Hugging the tummy in. Prayer twist to our right side. So really squeeze inside thighs, knees together, turn to the right, drop that left elbow, and press the right hand nicely down into that left arm. Feel the spaciousness around the torso here as you sit that tail down a little bit deeper. Keep hugging the tummy in. Lovely. And then we'll take it into a forward fold. Lift length of the legs at all four corners of the feet. Okay. Feel the length not only through the back of the legs, but the lovely lift and lengthen through the front of the legs. And then we'll roll it all the way up again, reaching the arms up. Exhaling hands to heart, that recentering again, just bringing us into a nice space. And then we will come back into our chair pose. Sending the tailbone down, relaxing the shoulders as much as we can. And we'll bring the hands to prayer, heart center, pushing the hands against one another to get the rotation checking, the knee alignment, and that we haven't swung our lovely left knee or right knee in front of the other one. But pressing down with the left hand. Lifting with the left ribcage and drawing that right side through. And sitting down another little bit. Lovely. From here, we'll fold it out. Fold, fold, fold. It's really letting it go. Inhale into our half. Hugging that lovely tummy. Hands on shins if necessary. And as we exhale, plant the hands and just hop, step, or jump, or walk back into our plank pose. Exhale, we'll bring the shoulders forward, softening down into the mat. Come either into a cobra or our upward facing dog. Just hold which one you've chosen for a few breaths here. Just allow the softness into the hips, into the back. And as we exhale, we'll lift up those lovely hips and back into our downward facing dog. And just stabilize here for a few breaths. Feeling the lovely gentle reach out to the heels. Lovely. From here we're going to float up our right leg nice and high to the sky. Step it in a low lunge position. Inhale, we'll come up into our high lunge. Good. As we exhale to plant the hands very carefully, we're taking that right leg back up to the sky. Where we're then going to eyeline our left little finger side and bring our right foot across side edge, up as high as we can go, and reaching around. Press the floor away with your right hand. Good. Keep that back heel lifted. as we take the left hand down, we're going to bring that right leg all the way back, arches back. Lovely. And then we're going to look at our right little finger side and bring our foot across. So we're nice and wide. Plant that foot and inhale, reach your right arm to stay. Now really press the left hip towards the left elbow rather than rolling in. Little turn around. Stretching across the front body here. Lovely. And then as we take that hand down, that leg's coming up. One more time. Up to the sky. And this time we're going to come onto the sole of our left foot, bring the right knee through, grab our lovely big toe and stretch it across. So lifted fallen angel here. And then again, when we're bringing it back, we want to shoot that lovely leg up to the sky. Come down onto our left knee. Swing the foot out a little bit, bring the right foot down, sole of the foot, left arm stabilizes under the left shoulder, reach the right arm up to the sky. Lovely. Reach the right arm overhead, press the fingertips away, and feel that side body real length. Good. Now we're stabilizing into this left shift, we're reaching back, we're reaching up for our right leg, finding our right ankle, pressing the knee out, okay? Foot into the hand, shoulder back. And then as we stabilize, hands down, knees, hips width, just gently bring yourself up into your kneeling position. So we really want to place onto the knees. We're going to bend our left knee, hug the left heel into the butt cheek. Not a massive core stretch, but for some maybe. And we're going to try to slide down the side of the glute as well if you can. Tailbone down to the floor. You'll feel this right through the rims of your pelvis. And then we'll swap it around the other way. So really pressing the knee into that, hugging the heel in, reaching our left arm up, tailbone down. Okay. So if you're easily reaching your butt cheek, swing the foot out a little bit wider, try and bring it to the side of your hip. So it's like a kneeling, reclined hero leg. Lovely. And then as we release that down, let's come into your hair pose. Big breaths into your back here. Hair pose extended, tabletop to our down facing dog. We're gluing into those lovely feet. This time we'll inhale our left leg up nice and high, step it in. So think low lunge position before you float those arms up into your high lunge. Relax the shoulders. As you exhale, to take the hands down, that left leg, sweep it all the way up to the sky. And we're going to eye-line our right leg to the side and bring it across. Reach up, take your back to the left, but don't spin onto the sole of that foot. Slow and strengthening here. As we bring that right hand down, that left leg is going all the way back up to the sky. Well, we'll eye-line our left little finger side and step that foot to the outside edge. So we're in a lizard pose effectively here. Right arm stays on, left arm reaches up. Right hip goes towards right elbow, and we're reaching across. And then as we pop that hand down, we're going to really push the hands open, lift that lovely leg up. So this time now, when we bring it in, we're rolling onto the sole of our right foot, spinning that left leg through, grabbing our toe, and lifting the leg up. Keep breathing through this. Lovely. And then as we come back up, that leg's coming up high. We're dropping onto our right knee, splaying the foot out a little bit wider, dropping the left foot. Stabilizing, if you need to move your hand underneath the shoulder. Lovely. And we'll bring that left arm up and over. Reach out to the fingertips. And then as we lift that leg, we're sweeping back, we're finding the foot, pressing the knee away from you and the foot away from you. And then as we bring ourselves back to center, the back onto those knees, curl the toes under, take a sit back onto your heels, hands onto your knees, Relax the shoulders. So just finding a little pause point here, let the breath slow, don't speed it up too much. Lovely, and then we're going to lift up, we're going to just plant the tops of the feet down, and then sit back onto those heels now, feeling the stretch through the shins. And then we'll sweep the hands back, place them along the soles of the foot, okay? So you're kind of holding your feet, and then gently lift those lovely hips up. So a nice backwards camel pose. So push the hands into the feet, press the hips forward. Roll that lower front chest wall up to the chin. You can let the hair drop down if you want, but keep pressing the hips forward. Lovely. And then as we release it out, we're going to bring ourselves back into that lovely hair pose. Hair pose into an extended table. Lovely curl of the toes under and float the knees off the mat down, facing dog. So we're breathing steadily and evenly here. So grounding our left foot, we're going to float that right leg up to the sky. As we step the right foot in, think warrior one, so swivel that left heel down. Get that lovely placement and just bring your hands to heart center. So extending that left hip forwards here. We're going to reach the arms out in front of us, float them up, and then bring them into little goal post arms. So elbows out wide, which is a cactus arm. So really roll those shoulders back. Lift that lovely chest. We'll have a little drop back if you can. Good. And then we're just going to turn to the left, straighten out our right leg. Bring the arms in line. Okay. If you need to heel toe your right foot away a little bit, just to get a little bit more length, we'll extend over our left leg. Coming into a nice straight leg, reverse those arms. Good. So just keep thinking about the length that you want to achieve on both sides of the body. Up and over another little bit. So just incrementally giving yourself a little bit of a creep up and over. Maybe creep's not the right word. Smooth. Good. And then as we come back to centre, we're extending over that right leg. Floating down into our Trikonasana triangle. Draw that ribcage around, taking our right eyelids to that left thumb. Good. Lift into the left hip as well here. Okay. Sometimes it's kind of hard to roll the hip forward. We're going to lift up into that left hip. Lovely. And then we're going to bring that lovely left arm up and over. You can maybe come down onto the palm of your right hand if you can reach the floor. If not, you can rest the hand onto the shin. Lovely. One more breath in. Yeah, as we bend our right knee now, okay, we're going to sweep the arms around. If the right shoulder's kind of resting onto the inside of that right leg, we're going to come into a prayer position. Lift into that back inside leg. Okay, so now we're eyeliner past our right big toe, okay, right little toe side, should I say, because we're going to bring ourselves into a nice spring into Ardha Chandrasana. So once you swallow and slip the arms over, really lift into that lovely left side. Gently turning the ideas. And this is always the leg that I find most challenging. Okay, but we're staying with it. We're staying with that flow with our breath. Activating that back leg. We're hugging the tummy in. Good. A nice wingspan across those legs. Lovely. And from here, we can pop our hand up down on that because we want to send that left leg really far back. Virabhadrasana two legs. So make sure once you're up, you feel that you're nicely situated for your warrior two. Trunks facing out the front and arms are just gently lengthened out. And we'll turn our eye gaze to that right arm. So, again, just challenging by sitting a little bit deeper as we go. Lift that right thigh. Settle into your left butt cheek. Reversing over, left arm sweeps back, right arm comes up, and then up and over. Breathe. So just that incremental lift, up and over we go. And then we'll simply come nice right forearm, right thigh, palm of the hand facing up, keep this hip lifted. Lovely. And we'll bring this left arm over here. So you notice when everything goes over that front leg, then this back leg kind of weakens for us. We want to keep that active. Lovely. And then we'll reach the right arm up in a little overhead, two arm shoulder width. Turn that chest for another little bit. Good. So as we recenter, just take the hands onto the thighs and bring yourself around into your high lunge. Because often, if you might be a little bit too long for your high lunge, you're not going to look deep enough. Prayer twist. Left elbow over the right thigh. Press back into your left heel. Really retract into that heel. Turn around another way. Lovely. And then we're going to pop the fingertips on the floor. Just straighten your right leg a little bit. Get the bum. Maybe a little relax here because there's a lot of work going on into that right leg. Okay. From here, as we bend our right knee and swing forward, into our standing out. Good. From our standing out into our warrior three. Hug the tummy in, press back into that heel. Lovely. Swing that leg forward, swing that knee forward. Just lift it up. Breathe into your right leg. Just breathe into it. And then we'll come into tree pose. So we're going to anchor the left foot into the right hand side thigh. Bring the hands to the heart center. Keep pressing in. Lovely. Now as we release the foot, bring the knee out right. Okay? This is a little challenging. I know those right glutes are probably on fire. Okay? We're going to send the foot back, keep the knee bent. And as we reach down to the floor, okay, we're going to come back with our right hand, find our left foot, and press the knee up to the sky. Yeah. Brilliant. Lovely. It's a very careful place to come now. So as you bring the hands down, we're going to step that left foot back 2.5 to 3. Think of your warrior, one leg, and gently bring yourselves up. Straighten out that front leg. All those sensations die out of that right leg. We'll bring the arms behind the back, interlace the fingers, lift and roll the shoulders back. Exhaling, nice deep fold, right down the middle of the mat. Hands back in asana, let it go. One more breath, reach the arms up and over now. And then we'll bend that right knee, pop the two hands down, fingertips spin onto the ball of our left foot. Reach that right leg up to the sky. Bend the knee, press the knee up high. Release that lovely hip as you sink down into your right hip, left hip. So also we're going to highlight our lovely right little finger side again. We're going to bring our right foot there. Shimmy away that left leg, so we're in a wide-based, low lunge position. You can pop your back knee on the mat if you need to. We're going to walk the hands forward and then gently press the forearms down towards the mat. Breathe. Nice deep hip stretch here. Popping the two hands onto the mat, drop that left knee nice and wide. Okay. Soften onto the top of the foot. Turn the right foot out. Roll onto the side edge of the foot. Gently press the right hand onto the right inside thigh. Just let that knee roll out wide. At this point, you can creep back leg back another little bit. And adding on by reaching back for half quad. So hugging that back heel into our butt cheek, letting our left brain drop out nice and wide. Pull that pelvis really soften
down into the mat. Lovely. From here, as we release that foot, straighten out your right leg. Okay. When you lift your back knee, when you walk around to the left side of the mat, you've got one foot in front of the other. Okay. So level them out, make sure they're nice and parallel. So your heel of your left foot runs through the middle of the mat, and here is your right foot runs to the back of the mat. Square off those over your hips and just fold it out. Make sure you're feeling balanced through the four corners of the feet. So we're just hanging out here, having a little tilt up. Good. Chipping the fingertips onto the floor. We're going to walk it around to that left foot, roll onto the side edge. Come into that pigeon pose. So just change your position down the mat. Because if you're like facing the front, you need to do the same thing. Just bring that left leg through. So, as we come into our pigeon pose, really drawing that right leg back. Good. Feel that toe under, stretch that leg back and up a little bit. Okay, smooth out that left butt cheek. Brilliant. Placing ourselves nice and upright. We're activating that back leg. So place your left hand into the middle. Push into the knee, reach back with your right hand, find that right foot, right ankle. Now push the foot back. Okay, bring this left chest, this kind of ribcage, right ribcage forward a little bit so that you're not pulling back. Okay, pop it in, reach back if you can with the other hand. Now you don't have to do two hands. Okay, we've got that ribcage really forward facing here. Then you can have just one hand on the mat. Push the foot back another little bit. Lovely. So as we release, okay, I'm going to swing that right leg over so that our right ankle bone sits onto our left inside leg. Okay. Let the knee just soften down. Okay. So, and then shimmy that left foot forward. Re-square off the pelvis and we're coming just gently into our firework pose. Now I know I use the words gently, a little bit cheekily, because this is quite strong on the hips. So just relax. We're not looking for perfection. We're not looking for full pose. We're just looking for that journey. Okay? So some days the journey seems extremely tough. Other days the journey is easier. Okay? And where would we be if the journey was so easy that we could do everything? They wouldn't be bothered with doing much, would we? So, embrace the fact that, you know, these things challenge us. Last breath here. Remember, just sit up nice and tall. If you roll back, you lose the hip. Good. And then from here, as you release the legs, we're going to come into our boat pose. And just breathe there. Lovely. So from here, lovely little cross of legs. We'll hop back into our plank pose. Exhaling again. Picking either your cobra or your upward facing dog, feet hips width. And we'll exhale into our downward facing dog. Just breathe and press down into those heels. Lift the sit bones. Feel how nice and restorative downward facing dog can be sometimes, you know, when you've really worked one side of the body, just feels like I can pull all together here. Love it. So we're going to inhale, float that left leg up. Step that left foot in, think about your warrior bow. And as you come up, we're just bringing hands to heart center. Okay? So just noticing how the back hip's working for you here. Getting the depth that you need usually sometimes helps you when you're coming into your trigonometric triangle. So you're going to extend the arms forward, reach them up and overhead, and bring them into those lovely goalpost cactus shape arms. Press back, bend into that left knee. And then as we turn to the side edge of the mat, just straightening out the leg, feeling that you've got adequate distance between the front and the back leg, reach the arms out, lifting up.
front now the way is just taking it down that right leg first. Little side stretch. Lifting up and out a little bit more, a little bit more side stretch. Ooh. Smooth out into that left foot. Sometimes we end up squeezing the toes into the floor. Brilliant. So when we're coming into our Trikonasana, remember we're kind of trying to insert ourselves into a little narrow space here. Good. So everything lines up through the line of the body. We'll turn our left leg gaze up to our right thumb. Good. Bring the hand down onto the floor. Bring the hand down onto the floor. Or else just place the hand onto the shin for a little bit of stability. We'll bring that right arm up and over and press right out to the fingertips. Draw back into our hip. Lovely. We'll take a little bend into that knee. So now that left shoulder's there, bringing our hands to prayer. Keep lifting into that right hip. So we've got that angle of our back leg already for our Ajna Shavasana. So you're eyelining that left little toe side. You're reaching across and you're floating that leg up. Once you've stabilized into those lovely toes, reaching up to the sky. Lovely. Relax the shoulder. This upper shoulder particularly. Brilliant. So we're going to step back really far. So we can pop the hands down and take that leg back. Virabhadrasana 2. So just settle first before we move through this part of our flow. Feeling that lovely open front pelvis. And they fix the clothes. And then we'll bring the arms out in line with the shoulders and gently turn our elbows along that left arm. Brilliant. We'll pop into the reverse, just a lovely little lateral stretch over that right leg. Soften down and up a little bit. Beautiful. And then as we bring ourselves through centre, left forearm rests on left thigh, and our right arm reaches across our right ear. Turn into it. So don't lose energy by not lifting the pelvic floor and drawing the tummy in gently. Bring it out into a lovely over shoulder shape. Brilliant. So when we're coming into this, use your hands to gently guide you around into your high leg. Okay? Reset into that position, hands to pray, right elbows coming to that left thigh. Good. Don't press back into that heel. Turn around the body. Super, nice and strong. So once we're here, we're going to take the fingertips off. We're going to straighten that front leg a little bit. And give the bum a little shift. Press up onto the heel, okay? Because we are building, okay? We're using those muscles on a consistent level. So sometimes they just need a little break. And then as we come forward, we're coming into our standing L. Checking the alignment, hugging the tummy in into our warrior three. Press into that big toe. Lovely. Now as we bring it up, I know that left leg's on fire. Just lift the knee. Breathe. Let the sort of over sensations gently drag down. And then we'll come into tree pose. As you press that left thigh against your right foot, breathe. Hands just a prayer in our center. Lovely. So our position here is we release the foot, we start swinging the foot back. Okay. As we release down to the floor, left arm's coming for our right foot. Lift the knee up high. Good. Beautiful. So a very careful position, place on position of our right foot as we come back 2.5 to 3. Gently bring yourselves up. Keep those hips nice and straight.
gonna swing the arms around as well as the fingers. Lift your elbows really, standing right up into that chest wall, and down you go. Parasvapanasana.
Swing the arms overhead. Good, strong breaths here. Over another little bit. Lovely. So as we release the hands, we're bending that knee, we're coming onto the ball of our right foot. We're pressing that left leg up high to the sky, bending the knee and pushing the knee up. Okay? You need to maybe rotate your left ankle a wee bit. So from here, we're lining our left little finger side. So we're bringing that left foot right across the mat. Shimmy it out into your low lunge position. Okay? Wide base. Walk the hands forward, keep the left knee stabilized over the left ankle, and we're just bending forward and center the mat. So you can just be here, okay? Don't have to have it all the way down, just where you're feeling it. Really square off the pelvis here. Press back into that back heel. Lovely. And then we'll pop the right knee down behind the elbow. Press up onto the two hands. Turn that left foot out. Roll onto the side edge. Just gently place the left arm. And turn the elbows across that left shoulder. So this is quite a nice release into the hip after all that work you've done. Maybe come to another walking that back leg another little bit. So when we reach back for that foot, we're hugging it into our butt cheek. But at the same time, we're letting that left knee roll out. Right hip towards right elbow, left knee out wide. Lovely, releasing that out. Straightening out that right foot, we lift that back knee. We're turning it around now to the side edge of the mat. So now our right foot's at the front part, and our left foot's at the back part. And we're just hanging out here. So you'll probably feel this in your right leg, in this kind of funny stance with one foot in front of the other. Just let it hang out. Let it drop down. Lovely. So when we're walking around to our right foot now, it just means all we have to do is kind of sneak the side edge of the foot onto the mat, drop the right knee out, and there we are nicely into our pigeon pose. So make those little minute adjustments that you might need to make to really stabilize through your pelvis here, left leg directly behind us, and we're lifting up. So there's nothing stopping you, maybe putting a block in underneath your hands, okay? One on the forearm, particularly when we're going to go and reach for our foot. Okay. But first, just keep getting the length into that back leg. Squaring off the pelvis. Oh, feeling that lovely stretch in our right hip. Good. So we're reaching for that foot now. Okay, just place your right hand in. We're trying not to drop down here. Okay, bend the neck and we'll find that ankle. Okay, so once we've reached back, if we've had to turn this rib cage across to the right alignment, once you've got it, turn it forwards again. Okay, push the foot actively into the hand. Okay, when you reach back, you might have to bring your foot in another little bit, but then once you've got it, push it back again. Good. And you will find one side to more challenging. Then the other, keep softening into that left hip flexor. Press the foot back another little bit. Feel like you're pressing the left hip kind of forward to the front wall. Lovely. Now as we release that foot, we're swinging it around. So we're taking this left ankle bone and placing it on the inside. hand side. Whoo! Of our right leg. So upside down. So just feel how that feels first, okay? Because you can very tight in this hip. And then we'll just shimmy this lovely right foot forward so that the side knee ends up onto the inside of the bone. Square off our lower pelvis. And then just gently drop down into it. So again, you probably find one side's tighter than the other. That is fine. Just breathe into it. Just remembering, if it wasn't challenging, why would you be doing it? So thinking, yay, this is fun. Lovely. And just breathing. As you might see, I've got my forearm on my thigh, my knee, and I'm holding onto my toe. Kind of gives it a little bit of an anchor as well. So if you're feeling you need that extra bit of engagement, just incrementally working it that way. Remember, we're sitting up nice and tall so that we really keep the sensations in the two hips. Lovely. As we release back, we're going to bend the knees. Okay. We're going to cross our right leg over our left. Okay. Hold on to the side edge of our left foot. Okay. Hold on to the side edge of our right foot. And then we're going to straighten the two legs. Now, if the two legs don't straighten, keep your right leg bent. Okay, so we're coming into a nice, almost like what we call cow's face boat pose. Okay. If then you can try and press into this hand and into this foot, we're straightening. Squeeze those inside thighs as we want to pull the feet down. Elbows curl back so we're sitting up nice and tall. Lovely. So we'll re-bend those lovely knees, pop the feet down, and just simply change across the legs. Really nicely hugged over. We're coming down for the side edges of our feet. Yeah. We're trying to straighten the two legs, but if the two legs don't want to straighten, you're straightening your right leg and letting the left knee bend. Okay. Once you're there, see if you can straighten the other leg as well. Shoulders roll back, we're balanced on our sit bones. Really feel you're popping those sit bones down into the floor. Lovely. And then as we release it down, just unhook the legs. Make sure your bones are in the middle now. Just gently roll down the spine, walk the feet in 2 to 3 inches away from the back of the feet, hips width. Sway the arms away from the body, palms, hands facing the ceiling, gently press up into a bridge pose. Softening to the back of the neck. Okay, and as you lift the hips up, send the knees forward slightly, but then lengthen, send like a line of energy through your rib cage, right up into this little side rib cage. Okay, so feel that lovely lift. Good. Rest it up. One more big breath. So lovely. And then as we gently peel and roll back down, soften the back into the mat. Lovely. And we're going to walk the feet in a little bit closer. Okay, and see if we find our front ankles. So the heels might have lifted from the floor here. Okay. We're going to just try that one more time. So we're holding onto the front ankles, you press the feet into the floor, and lift it up. Now, if that doesn't work for you, just come back into an ordinary bridge pose with your arms directly underneath you, or beside you, should. Press the feet in, lift those hips up. Roll that lovely front chest wall into your chin. Lovely. And then just gently peeling when the heels come off, smooth the back into the mat. Bring the arms away from the body, heel toe, the feet out a little bit wider. Just Just rock the knees from side to side. And then we'll heel toe those feet together. Okay. Cross the right leg over. Heel toe the left foot out again a little bit and drop the knees out to the right. And I'll really exaggerate that little softness of the upper body into the floor. We'll gently turn the head to the left, relaxing into the shoulders, the neck, the head, the hips, everything. Brilliant. And then as we sweep it back to our center plank, just straightening everything out. Left leg goes over here, turn the right foot out a little bit, drop the knees out to the left. And again, just really drop into the earth below you. And we'll gently draw the head to the right. Center point, we're going to really smooth into that lower back. Just gently pick the knees up top and into the chest. And then we'll gently slide the legs and feet away. Just coming into our Shavasana. Okay, so really almost starting from your belly button, softening right down into your mat, and then spread it through the limbs, the chest, the arms, the head. Imagine you're so light that someone could just gently lift you by one hand and float you up to the sky. So you've got this real sense of trust. And let yourself just fall into the earth. Gently scan your body, just emotionally, physically. How do you feel right here, right now? Do you feel like all the nerves are nicely tingling while you're waking up and doing this lovely flow on the mat? Or is there an area that you feel you might need to adjust so that you can relax into it a little bit? So just gently observing the body, like scanning it from top to toe. Start with your toes, working them with the feet, upper legs, into the pelvis, the tummy, the torso, the chest, the arms, the shoulders, the neck, and then finally the head. And just think, how am I relaxing my head? My whole intention through all the muscles in my face, the muscles in the front of my neck. Even around the scalp, just let the head fall into the floor. As we switch from doing to just simply being, notice that sense of just peace. And down us. Lovely. So just gather yourself now for the rest of this beautiful day. We'll roll out the toes, we'll roll out the fingers. Take a nice big breath in and then just move into that lovely all over body stretch. And we'll just again walk the knees and gently soften into our lower backs. Hug the knees in, give ourselves a good tight hug. Press the breath into the back.
Exhale, release and out. And then we can jump, come up to sit.
So at this point, well done everybody.
Namaste.
Have a fabulous weekend.